able to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 5, heat and temperature. Before coming to the topic, few examples are here. Just listen it carefully. First example is the spread of color. Take 3 glass and fill 1 glass with refrigerated water, that means chilled water. Second with tap water, that means normal. And the third one with food color in each one by one. What you will observe that the food color spreads faster in the third glass, that means in which the temperature is more, in that the food color spreads faster. So temperature helps in the spread of the molecules. Second, during winter we feel cold and try to maintain our body temperature by taking a cup of tea or coffee. On the other hand, during summer season, we try to maintain our body temperature by taking chilled drink or chilled fruits. So, how do we come to know which object is hotter than the other? It is done by a device called thermometer. And for this, there is exchange of heat, and so we have to learn more about the concept of heat and temperature. So first is the concept of heat. In our daily life, we come across with many objects which is hot or cold. How we decide it? Which one is hot or which one is cold? The best method is by touching. The sense of touch is make us feel the hotness or coldness of the object. If we have ice cold water or ice, then by touching it with our finger, we feel that it is cold. Same as if we sip a hot soup or hot tea, then by touching with our tongue, when it comes in contact with the tongue, then we feel it is hot. But in all these above example, the hotness or coldness of the drink is subjective. It varies from person to person. That means it is relative. The hotness or coldness of the object is relative. It depends on person to person. It varies from person to person. If a person is in hot room and coming out, then he will feel in somewhat other manners, whereas the person is coming from AC room. So the sense of touch is relative. One activity is here to prove that our sense of touch is relative. Material required: a piece of wood and a piece of metal. Touch the piece of wood and piece of metal with your hand at room temperature. Then, to get a better standing, put a cube of ice on each and then touch them with the ice has melted. What you will observe that the piece of metal feels cooler than the piece of wood, because if piece of wood, as heat is removed faster from your hand by the piece of metal. When we touch the metal is a good conductor of heat, so when we touch it, the heat from our hand, it passes to the metal and it is felt colder than the wood. So the degree of hotness or coldness of a body is known as temperature. And the temperature of an object is measured by the device which is known as thermometer. So measuring temperature, it is measured by using thermometer. There are three types of thermometer: mercury thermometer, alcohol thermometer and digital thermometer. Mercury thermometer, in which the mercury is used, because the property of mercury is it is liquid at room temperature and it is gray in color. It is lustrous silver gray in color. So when it is used in thermometer, it expands when the temperature increases, and at the same time it is easy to read because it is silver gray color. Second, alcohol thermometer. Alcohol can also be used in thermometer because it is not as toxic as mercury. Mercury is toxic in nature. Toxic means poisonous. So in place of mercury, alcohol can also be used. And third is digital thermometer. They have thermistor inside them. The passage of current through it depends on the temperature that is being read. Another device measures the temperature and information is displayed on this screen is digital. That means the number displays on the screen of the thermometer and it is easy to read.